So hello students, in this video we will study the remaining articles of the Convention of Rights of Child. So before that I have explained up to article 21, so we'll study further, that is article 22, that is refugee children. Here what says, children have the right to special protection and help if they are any refugees means if they have been forced to leave their homes or to live in any country, as well as this all rights in this convention. Refugee means the children should have the right to protections if they have been any forced to leave their homes, means the government should take actions against them. That is called as article 22. Next is article 23, children's with disabilities, means here what happens, children who have any kind of disability, here they have the right to special care and support, as well as all the rights in this convention, so that they can live full and independent life. This is about article 23. Next is article 24, health and health services. Here children have the right to good quality of health care, means they should provide best health care possible to safe, like providing safe drinking water, like proper nutrition food, as well as a clean and safe environment and information to help them stay healthy. Rich countries should help poor countries achieve this. Okay, here health means we should provide proper health services. We should provide them safe drinking water, proper food, proper clean water, and safe environment. That says article 24. Next comes article 25, revive of treatment in care. Here children who are looked after by their local authorities rather than their parents have the right to have these living agreements looked at the regularly to see if they are the most appropriate. This care treatment should always be based on the best interest of the child. That says article 25. Next, article 26, it says about social security, means children's either through their guardians or directly have the right to help from their government if they are poor in need. Means government should provide social security to the children's to help from their government if they are poor or in need. Next, article 27, adequate standard of living, means good standard of living should be provided. Here children's have the right of to a standard of living that is good to enough to meet their mental needs as well as physical needs. Here government should help to those families and guardians who cannot afford to provide this, particularly with regard to food and clothing of house. Next comes article 28, right to education. Here what happens, all children have the right to get a primary education, which should be free, and wealthy countries should help poor countries to achieve this right, as well as there should be a discipline in schools to teach them respect children's dignity, as well as for the children to get benefit from their educations. And here school must be run in a proper way of manner without the use of violence, as well as any form of school discipline should take in the account the children should get a proper dignity. Therefore here government should ensure that school administrator revive their discipline in the policies and should eliminate any discipline practices involving like physical or mental violence or abuse. Next comes आर्टिकल 29 गोल्स ऑफ एजुकेशन इन दिस चिल्ड्रंस एजुकेशन शुड डेवलप इन दैट ईच चिल्ड्रन शुड डेवलप देयर पर्सनैलिटी लाइक टैलेंट एंड एबिलिटीज टू डू समथिंग इट शुड एनकरेज दैट चिल्ड्रन शुड रिस्पेक्ट अदर्स एज वेल एज ह्यूमन राइट्स एंड देयर ओन एंड द अदर कल्चर्स इट शुड ऑल्सो हेल्प देम टू लर्न टू लीव इन अ पीसफुल मैनर एज वेल एज टू प्रोटेक्ट द एनवायरमेंट एंड रिस्पेक्ट अदर पीपल्स हियर चिल्ड्रन शुड हैव अ पर्टिकुलर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू रिस्पेक्ट द राइट्स देयर पेरेंट्स एंड एजुकेशन शुड एम टू डेवलप रिस्पेक्ट फॉर द वैल्यूज एंड कल्चर ऑफ देयर पेरेंट्स नेक्स्ट कम्स आर्टिकल 30 चिल्ड्रंस ऑफ माइनॉरिटीज एंड इंडिजीनियस ग्रुप्स हियर माइनॉरिटी पीपल्स और इंडिजीनियस चिल्ड्रंस हैव द राइट टू लर्न अबाउट एंड शुड प्रैक्टिस देयर ओन कल्चर लाइक लैंग्वेज एंड रिलीजन दिस राइट प्रैक्टिस वंस ओन कल्चर लैंग्वेज एंड रिलीजन अप्लाइज टू एवरी वन चिल्ड्रन इन दिस द कन्वेंशन हियर हाईलाइट्स दिस राइट इज इंस्टेंस विथ प्रैक्टिस आर नॉट शेयर्ड बाय द मेजोरिटी ऑफ पीपल इन द कंट्री नेक्स्ट कम्स आर्टिकल 31 लीजियर कॉमा प्ले एंड कल्चर इन दिस एवरी चिल्ड्रंस हैव द राइट टू बी रिलैक्स एंड टू बी प्ले एंड टू ज्वाइन इन द वाइड रेंज ऑफ कल्चरल एंड अदर रिक्रिएशनल एक्टिविटीज नेक्स्ट कम्स आर्टिकल 32 चाइल्ड लेबर हियर द गवर्नमेंट शुड प्रोटेक्ट चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम वर्क दैट इज डेंजरस और माइट हार्म देयर हेल्थ और देयर एजुकेशन वाइल दिस कन्वेंशन protects children from harmful and exploitative work there is nothing in that it prohibits parents from accepting their children to help out at home in ways that are they should be safe and appropriate to their age as well as if children help out in a family like a farm or a business the tasks they do be safe and suited to their level of development and comply with national labor laws next comes article 33 drug abuse here government should use all means of possible and to take strict action to protect from children from the use of harmful drugs as well as from being used in drug trade of buying and selling of drug next comes article 34 sexual exploitation here government should protect children from all forms of sexual exploitations and abuse in this provision in the convention is augmented by the optional protocol to protect from the sale of children and to protect from the child prostitution next comes article 35 abduction sale and trafficking here government should take all measures possible to make sure that children are not abused or sold or trafficking means buying and selling of children and this provision in this convention is augmented by the optional protocol means here the children should be protected from the sale of children and child prostitution next comes article 36 others form of exploitation here means children should be protected from any activity that take advantage of them or could harm their welfare and development next comes article 37 detention and punishment here no one child is allowed to punish children in a cruel or harmful way. Children who break the law should not be treated cruelly or harmfully. They should not be put in prisons or in jail with adults, should able to keep in contact with their families, and should not be sentenced to death or life imprisonment without possibility of relax. Next comes Article 38. Here what Article 38 says about war and armed conflicts, means arm and war conflict, means any problems happens within the other countries. Here what does government must do everything that they can protect and care for children affected by the war. Children under 15 should not be allowed to force or to join to take part in the war or to join the armed force. Next comes Article 39, rehabilitation of children's victims. Children who have been neglected or abused or exploited should receive special help to physically and psychological to recover and reintegrate into the society. It means particular attention should be paid to restore the health as well as self-respect as well as dignity of the child. Next comes Article 40, juvenile justice. Means here children who are accused of breaking the law have the right to legal help and fair treatment in the justice system and respect their rights. Governments are required to set a minimum age below which children cannot be held criminally responsible and to provide minimum guarantees for the fairness and quick resolution of judicial or alternative proceedings. Article 41, respect for superior national standards. If the laws of a country provide better protection of children's or child rights, then the articles in this convention, those laws should be applied. Next, Article 42, knowledge of rights. Government should make the convention known to adults as well as children. Adults should help the children learning about their rights. Means here the adults should help the children to tell what is right and what is wrong. And last is Article 43 to 54, implementation measures. Here means this article discuss how governments and international organizations should work to ensure children's protected in their rights. Means proper implementations and actions should be taken to protect the children.